Prisjećajući se dana kada je radio za NSA na tajnom prisluškivanju i praćenju, Edward Snowden objašnjava kako za njih sadržaj presretnih komunikacija nije bio od presudnog značaja. Ono što je za njih bilo važno su metapodaci, odnosno podaci o podacima koji daju odgovore na pitanja ko, kada, gde. Prikupljanjem velike količine metapodataka i njihovom obradom moguće je utvrditi obrasce ponašanja posmatranih osoba. Obradu takvih podataka ne vrše ljudi, već računari. Zato su metapodaci osmišljeni i formatirani na način da ih mogu procesuirati različiti algoritmi.
Algoritmi su bolja radna snaga od ljudi, čisto sa gledišta efikasnosti, zato što ne moraju nikad da spavaju, ne moraju da budu hranjeni, njima treba samo malo energije i mogu da nastave da rade svoj posao. A to je, da kažemo, neka kvantitativna dimenzija, jer ako mi imamo jednog dobrog digitalnog radnika, nas košta jako malo da ga iskopiramo virtualno i da imamo milion takvih radnika za bilo kakvu potrebu o kojoj se radi. Sa kvalitativne strane, algoritmi imaju druge prednosti, a to je da su u stanju da sagledaju mnogo veće količine podataka istovremeno i da pronalaze veze između podataka kojih se čovek, pod navodnicima, nikad ne bi setio. Razlog je, naravno, što smo mi evoluirali na jedan totalno drugačiji način i što je u stvari baza na kojoj mi funkcionišemo, bar koliko je poznato, totalno drugačije od digitalne tehnologije.
Kad studenti uče statističke testove, njih uče da razdvoje šta je zakonitost u odnosu na slučajnost. A algoritmi mašinskog učenja taj proces rade automatski. I tu je velika prednost. Obično u klasičnoj statistici morali smo da postavimo hipotezu da li je nešto zakonitost, onda da proveravamo nekim statističkim testovima, dok algoritmi mašinskog učenja su napravljeni tako da automatski iz podataka izvlače zakonitost.
Often we see that certain algorithms can be a huge help in supporting staff with their decision making. So you can see this, for example, in healthcare, where if we have a doctor making a diagnosis that is supported by a machine learning algorithm that has been trained to recognize certain symptoms and patterns, then that can be a hugely helpful thing.
One of the online dating platforms, OkCupid, they tested on their users different types of algorithms without telling their users beforehand to see whether the algorithm was working or not. And from a scientific point, it makes sense to test and see whether your algorithm works. From a scientific point, you should always also have the consent of the people you're testing things on before you test them on them. And so, essentially, this automated system, which is supposed to help you find better dates than just asking somebody or taking a random person, actually sent people on bad dates that they knew were bad dates to see whether the dates would be bad.
Svakog dana, svako od nas koristeći računare, mobilne telefone, bankarske usluge, platne kartice, kartice za gradski prevoz, generiše veliku količinu metapodataka koje bivaju prikupljene najčešće od velikih privatnih kompanija. Nakon što te podatke obrade putem svojih algoritama, oni kreiraju naše profile. Upravo za te naše profile zainteresovane su kako državne službe, kao što su policija i obaveštene agencije, tako i kompanije i prodavci najrazličitijih roba i usluga.
It's easy for us to think that our pieces of data are like dandruff or little cookies we lose or little pieces of rubbish that have no value to anybody, even not to us. Because if you look at data traces separately, you will see numbers like IP number, maybe phone number, maybe a call log, maybe log from the server. What does it mean at all, right? It's tempting to think that all those little pieces, they are meaningless, they don't have big commercial value, and they cannot have real impact on my life. Why should they? This is our perspective of individuals. It looks very differently from the perspective of those who collect all those little pieces of rubbish we leave behind, all those little traces, and create meaningful profiles.
U savremenom svetu, odgovori na pitanja kao što su: ko je potencijalno izvršila terorističkog napada? Kome će biti odobren kredit za stan? A kome ponuđena probna vožnja novog modela automobila donose računari, a ne ljudi.
What we need to be very watchful of is that we ascribe to algorithms this sense of sort of objective idea that it must be true because it is a computer. And when a computer says that something is the case, we start to think like computers as well, in a sense where we are very binary in that, you know, this is the decision the computer has made, so it must be the correct decision.
Police is often not able to explain us why they believe that something is suspicious, certain behavior is suspicious. They say, well, the correlation has been detected by analyzing big data sets, and they act upon that knowledge. But the way that knowledge is produced is not transparent, so the designer cannot really say what was the logic that resulted in a certain decision. And here come the problem of black boxes, algorithmic black boxes that we have to solve.
Of course, algorithms make things more efficient, but a government can't have efficiency as the only goal. A government needs to be legitimate.
And the challenge of that is that there are, so far at least, relatively few legislative acts or government mechanisms that allow for individuals to be able to have control over this. And this is both the case for public sector automation and the case for private sector automation. There's a very low degree of transparency, there's almost no accountability, and there's a situation for individuals where they would like to know a lot more in many cases, especially when they experience negative effects, but they don't have control over that themselves. They don't have the ability to understand what's going on, not just because they lack the technical expertise, but because they're not provided with basic information about the decisions that are being made.
It's going to be a big challenge for technologists, lawyers, advocates to come together and define what it really means to reveal the logic behind the algorithm. My suggestion would be to start with something quite simple, to reveal what kind of data is taken into account, what kind of outputs, categories, ideas about humans are produced at the end of that process, and what was the logic, meaning why certain feature was relevant in the context of certain outcomes. So for example, if I discover that I'm suspicious for the police, they should explain to me what data on me they had in the first place, what is their decision regarding me, and why, simply why, they believe that because of my color, because of my gender identity, because of my ethnicity, why that mattered in naming me a suspect. If they cannot explain that, for me it becomes very problematic, and it should be changed.